Yes, indeed. We are actually worried. I think populist politics, when it comes to economic policy at least, has not shown to be very performant, you know. So I think that we have to stay away from that kind of approach. At least what the Spanish government thinks is that what we need is to strike the right balance between fiscal discipline, which we're absolutely committed to, and taking care of the people. You know, trying to, for example, fight inequality, which has risen a lot in Spain. So far, so good. I think that the Spanish population generally is supporting this balanced approach, and we're going to keep on that line.
Minister, when we saw the this extraordinary exchange between Mr. Trillo and his own government and Mr. Trillo and the Commission about whether they were going to come in at 2.4 deficit or 2.04 as well, I couldn't help thinking that there were semantics going on here as well, because we know that the Italian growth assumptions were a little bit generous, to say the least, as well. Let me take this back to Spain as well and say, at a 2.7% budget deficit figure, where you are spending more, you are looking at your taxation regime, you're looking at government spending to negate some of those concerns as well, you're quite near the mark on breaching limits as well over in Spain. You're running it as tight to the 3% level as you possibly dare.
Oh, no, not at all. No, this was 2018. Mm. In 2018, we expect to close with 2.7%, which is a very significant reduction as compared to the previous year. And our approach this year is to have a target of 1.3%.
Wow.
So, no, actually, we're absolutely committed to budgetary
growth assumptions, Minister?
Well, I mean, we just issued our latest assumptions. We expect growth in 2019 to reach around 2.2% in Spain, which is above the EU average, above the largest economies in Europe. This is actually the expectation of all international and national forecast institutions. The IMF just issued the forecast, and Spain was the only country that has not been downgraded or revised downwards. So, you know, we think this is a prudent assumption for 2019, and this is the framework within which we think that we have to be ambitious in terms of deficit reduction, debt reduction, you know, take the advantage of this growth to reduce our imbalances.
The trouble is, you're surrounded by countries in the Eurozone that are exhibiting slower growth trends at this point. Are you concerned at all that your core assumptions may be damaged by the problems in Italy, the problems in France, the weaker growth in Germany?
Well, in the last 10 years, what has happened in Spain is we bounced back from the very deep crisis, very long crisis. We've shown quite dynamic growth, and part of this growth is coming from the increased internationalization of Spanish businesses. They have been very dynamic, they have been very competitive, they have found and grown in international markets. So, indeed, the Spanish economy is more open. We cannot be isolated from developments in Europe and elsewhere. Having said that, the assumptions we integrated into our macroeconomic forecast were already quite prudent and not very upbeat or optimistic. So, you know, for the moment, I don't think that we should revise them downwards. No, I think that this is a realistic assumption. But, of course, we're following very closely developments in the other European markets, because whatever happens in Germany, of course, it has an impact on all of us.